I make a simple table to remember. X is 0, true. X is 0, false. Accept X is 0 and reject X 0. Now see, if something is true and we are accepting it, that's okay. That's a very nice thing. But if something is true and we are rejecting it, this is error. If something is true and we are rejecting it, this is an error. If something is false and we are accepting it, again that becomes an error. If something is false and we are rejecting it, so this is quite okay. There are two types of error. When X is 0, true, we are rejecting it, and when X is 0, false, and we are accepting it. Now, the whole testing is divided into two parts. One is large sample test, other is small sample test. Generally, for n less than 30, we go for small sample test. And for greater than 30, we go for large sample test. N means the number of items we are using in the sample. So let us start today with a small sample test. Because generally, the small sample tests are very much useful in industry. And the small sample test, today, we'll go for t-test. Under t-test, we will going to study three tests. The very first one is test of significance for single mean. When I am talking of single mean, that means I am talking of sample and population. Fine. Now in this case, the null hypothesis generally will be x bar is equal to mu, where x bar denotes the sample mean. This is a standard notation. Mu stands for population mean. Alternate is, that depends whether not equal to greater or less. I think it is not equal to. Then level of significance, obviously it could be 5% or 1% or whatever is there. Now the formula, the test statistics used here is, this is t equal to x bar minus mu by s by root n. Now x bar is sample mean, mu is population mean. Small s, I use here symbol for standard deviation of n minus 1 values, whereas capital S n will be used for standard deviation of n values, and n is the number of items or number of values. Now to convert this standard deviation of n values into n minus 1 values, we are having two formulas. One is s square equal to n upon n minus 1 capital S square. Other is this one, if you are given the table. And the degree of freedom, this is n minus 1. This is used whenever we see the table. So I repeat it once. Small sample test, this is t test, test of significance for single mean. Single mean means sample and population. Null hypothesis is x bar equal to mu, h1 is x bar is not equal to mu, level of significance is 5% or 1%. The formula we will use here is t equal to x bar minus mu by s by root n. S stands for standard deviation of n minus 1 values, capital S for n values, and is the number of items. Just keep one thing in mind, whenever you are using this formula, you have to convert the standard deviation for n values into n minus 1 values. After this calculation, we are using the DF and the level of significance, we go for the table value, and after seeing the table, we have to go for the conclusion whether we have to accept this H0 or we have to reject.